AMD's Ryzen processors have been the preferred choice for quite some time now, but they also have a Ryzen Pro series of processors that have some special features that make them even more suitable for businesses and corporations. Hey guys, I'm Siddharth and we have the HP Zbook Power G11A featuring a Ryzen Pro series processor. The everyday person might not value features like RAID and out-of-band manageability, but just think about how much time you can save as a business if you can just update the software or change BIOS settings in hundreds of laptops in a few minutes, even when they are turned off. There is a lot going on with this laptop, but let's talk about the CPU first, and this is powered by AMD's Ryzen 5 Pro 8645HS processor. It's a middle-of-the-line hexa-core CPU with 12 threads based on the Zen 4 architecture. You can configure this all the way up to a Ryzen 9 8945HS Pro according to your needs. This lineup has the world's first dedicated AI engine for an x86 CPU, meaning that we have a neural processing unit inside this which will help out in the ever-increasing AI tasks that we are beginning to see everywhere. For example, a Photoshop user might use its neural filters to change details that may be impossible to change for a typical user, or you may make an Instagram promo for your business which requires Adobe Premiere Pro's auto reframing and auto captioning, which saves hours of work. Even Microsoft Windows itself is adding more and more AI features, so having a dedicated NPU with 16 TOPS of power will help a lot in these tasks, and this figure can reach 31 tera operations per second when the CPU, iGPU and the NPU work together. This is what the webcam on this laptop looks and sounds like, and now I will enable the background blur feature, which is also AI accelerated. You can also cover the camera with an inbuilt shutter so the AI on this laptop doesn't get to know what you are doing. Having a Ryzen Pro series CPU means that you have access to some exclusive business features like very advanced security with secure boot, memory guard and shadow stack. A lot of the advanced level cyber attacks originate from firmware level, so having technologies like this ensures that your computer doesn't just boot up and execute these hacks without even checking if it is secure. We also have Microsoft's Pluton security processor, which validates your system's code integrity so you don't run any tampered code, and it blocks access to encryption keys and your credentials, which are of course very important to secure. There are actually more advanced ways in which this protects your laptops, like authentication at chip level instead of the communication bus, but that will be overly advanced for this video, and I'm not sure if people who understand why it is better will be watching this, but if you are a security expert, please do let others know why it matters in the comments. Now just imagine that someone opens the cover of your laptop and changes some component inside. This laptop can inform you that someone has tampered with it with exact date and time, and it can also clear the TPM, so both your software and hardware is protected. We also have special manageability features, and I actually hate the word management as an MBA graduate because it can have so many vague meanings, but in this context, what it means is that you can do things like booting this up remotely and control things like security patches and diagnose any issues even when the OS of your devices is not working, which can be super crucial when things like CrowdStrike crashes happen. Your IT staff can also monitor laptops like this remotely and perform repairs at a scale, and I don't think that I need to tell you how life-changing it can be for a company. With great power, AMD also delivers on great efficiency with TSMC's 4nm process, and the 86Wh battery in this laptop lasted for 15 hours in my 1080p video streaming test. This is one of the best results that I have seen on a laptop, and you can expect similar efficiency while video conferencing as both tasks use the AV1 decoder by default. The NPU will also free up your CPU and iGPU, so in AI accelerated tasks, you should also see longer lasting performance. Speaking of the iGPU, it's a very important component which accelerates many tasks like your graphics, video playback and even some AI tasks. The Radeon 760M that we have built into this laptop supports AMD's Pro drivers, which are more suited for productivity apps, and here we are running some demanding games on it where we are also seeing impressive performance for an iGPU. In Cyberpunk 2077, which is very demanding, we can still get close to 50 FPS on low preset, which is awesome. Then in Rocket League on high settings, we get close to 100 FPS, making it super playable. And finally in Rainbow Six Siege, we got an average of 73 FPS even on its high preset. So when you are video editing or even using some 3D applications, this RDNA 3 based GPU will keep everything running smoothly. Do give this video a thumbs up if you are liking it so far. The laptop has a no-nonsense design with an aluminum chassis that is designed to pass military tests, and I really like the minimal HP logo on it. The display is a 16-inch IPS panel with a 1920x1200 resolution. You can also get a sharper panel with a 1600p version, or you can choose a super bright 1000 nits panel if you make your stuff work outside in the sun. We have a full-sized quiet keyboard with a number pad, and this is also spill resistant, so if your employees start crying while they are working, this laptop should still work fine. If they have to work at night outside of working hours, the three levels of backlighting on the keyboard will also ensure that lack of light is not an excuse. Since this is a Copilot ready laptop, we also have a dedicated key to launch it. On the left side, you will find two Thunderbolt 4 ports with power delivery input and display port out, an HDMI 2.1 port, and a good old USB A port with 5 Gbps speed. What surprised me was that all of the three ports on the left side can be used for charging your devices even when the laptop is turned off. We also have an active card slot here, which is used for some really high level security authentication, like actual military level stuff. Along with the Kensington lock on the right, we have an RJ45 LAN port, another 5 Gbps USB A port, a full-sized SD card slot, and even an optional SIM card slot. The fingerprint reader works very fast for signing in, and I thought that we won't have Windows Hello sign-in feature on the webcam because of it, but that feature is actually present, so we have three secure ways of signing in. Let's open this up now, and we have two M.2 slots here for NVMe hard disks, and you can select from 512GB to 4TB of storage. Generally, you only have one storage slot in laptops, but this one has two, and a big advantage of that is that you can configure two drives to be in RAID configuration, which means that this laptop will store your data to both drives at the same time, and it can be incredibly useful for your business because if SSDs crash, data recovery is almost impossible, and having RAID support in a laptop is quite rare. This model I have comes with 32GB of DDR5 RAM, and you can configure it from 16 to 64GB with a choice of single 32GB stick so you can upgrade it in the future, and this once again gives you so much flexibility right out of the box. The laptop comes with a 150W type C charger, which is quite slim for its wattage, and it charges the laptop quite fast. Since this is in HP's business lineup, we also get HP specific business features like Wolf security, BIOS updates over network, and HP Short Start, which also monitor unauthorized changes in BIOS, so we have a combination of security features from both HP and AMD. So the HP Zbook Power G11A is a device that has special features that will deliver to some very specific needs of your business that you won't be able to find on other laptops. The pricing on this laptop can vary a lot because there are so many configurations to choose from, so I will have links to check this out in the video description so you can get an idea of what exactly this would cost. Do remember that it is your company's money at stake and not your own, so do go ahead with that 1600p screen upgrade. Let me know your thoughts about these features in the comments. Thanks for watching this far, and I'll see you in the next one.